call me Cardi B. I run this shit like cardio. Diamond District in the chat.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the products I use to keep my curly hair hydrated with my highlights. So, I'm going to be talking about the products I use as far as shampoos, as far as deep conditioners, as far as oils. I'm going to be telling you all the things that I use to maintain my highlights, how often I did it, and overall, how is my experience having highlights on 3B3C hair. So if you want to hear what I have to say, stay tuned. Okay, so first things first, I've had my hair highlighted for 6 months now. I got my hair highlighted on November 25th. How has my hair been treating me is the real question. You know, everybody wants to know. They're like, is your hair brittle? Is your hair dry? Is your hair breaking off? Is the color, you know, turn orange? And honestly, no. And I haven't retouched my highlights. I did, however, you know, darken my roots. But as far as that, I had my hair highlighted ever since November. So this is my hair. If you guys watch my videos, from my hair videos, then you can see my highlights are still vibrant. So what I do for my hair, when you get highlights, especially on curly hair, you have to step up your hair, you know, regimen. You have to do it more than you used to do before you had your virgin hair, or when you had dark colored hair. You have to do it way more because your hair is lighter. So basically, I shampoo my hair maybe every 2 weeks. This can differ from different hair types. I know if you have like a looser curl pattern, you might have to shampoo more frequently than somebody who has a tighter curl pattern, just because of, you know, how the oils travel down from our scalp. So for me, what works for me is 2 weeks. So the weeks that I am not shampooing, I'm conditioning. And I'm conditioning using Ite. And their products are really good. I like this brand because it's a silk protein and boosts texture and creates body and volume. I also use a shampoo to this too. I mix it with apple cider vinegar, Bragg's only. I mix a little bit of this, the shampoo, and this together, and I use that as my shampoo, and then I use this as my conditioner. As far as deep conditioners, these are a major key when you have highlighted hair, major key in general if you have curls, but you know, when you have highlighted hair, like I said, you have to step it up. So this is a major key. So the two masks that I love are the Entwine hair mask, and this is 100% raw and vegan. So this is what it looks like. And this I really love. Look, I emptied that thing so fast. This probably lasts me 1 month. And the way I deep condition my hair is I deep condition every 4 days. I deep condition my hair. Sometimes I do, you know, wait a week, but I try to do every 4 days deep condition. And what I do, if I have time, I sleep with this in. I sleep with it overnight, and I put a plastic bag on my head and go to sleep. And that way, the heat just trapped, and so my hair is just marinating in this mask, just like as if you were marinating meat. You know, you let it sit for a day and then you fry it or bake it, whatever you do. So I let this sit in my hair for 1 day, and then I rinse it out with cold water. You have to use cold water. Seals the moisture in, closes your pores. Great thing to do. If I have a little more time on my hands, or if I just sometimes if I don't have time to have a whole day of deep conditioner, what I do is I sit under my hooded dryer and I sit under there for maybe half an hour and I deep condition. Another deep conditioner that I love is the Mix Chicks. This is the Mixed Chicks deep conditioner, and this one is not vegan or fair trade or any of those good things that I love, but this is also a really good deep conditioner. Ooh, and another one I don't have with me to show you, but I'll probably insert a picture here, and that is the Uidad Melt, Extreme Meltdown, or something like that. Picture will be over here. But that one, and also sometimes, not all the time, as often as I like to, but I do like to get the aloe plant, and I take all the aloe gel out of the plant, and I put that on my hair, and I don't go under the dryer, I just sit. Maybe I just wash up and I let it sit in my hair and I rinse it out while I'm still in there. And that leaves your hair so soft. I'm telling you, if you can't afford these, just get the aloe plant. It's probably like $3. Very cheap and very easy to find. So a few other things that I like to use. I like to use the Shea Moisture Leave-In Conditioner. I like to use this once I get out the shower. This is my leave-in, my LOC method. This is the L. And then the oil I use, I like this. This is my fave oil. This is grapeseed oil. The grapeseed oil, I love this oil. If you don't know about grapeseed oil, let me tell you. So this oil is very lightweight formula and it's perfect for curls. It doesn't, especially if you have 3B, 3C, even 3A here. Well, 3A, 3B, and 3C here. This oil is perfect to use because it's very light. It doesn't weigh down your curls and it smells amazing. It's the OGX Marula oil. I'm not crazy about this one. I think I want to get like a natural organic one, but this one is just from OGX and it's okay. It's an oil, you know, it does what it does. Okay, for my creams, I like to use, my favorite is right now, is the Cantu Natural Hair Conditioning Cream. And this is nice. It's nice. It does the job. It does moisturize the hair. When I touch my hair the next day, I could still see the grease, so I know my hair is moisturized. So that's a good thing. And then I love the Marc Anthony Curls, Strictly Curls line. And this is his Curl Defining Lotion. And then I just started using this one. This is really nice. It's very lightweight, though. I don't really like lightweight creams, but I do like the scent, so I do in my braid outs, you know. In my protective styling, I will use this. But for my wash and goes, I gotta use my heavier creams. But this is the OGX Coconut Curls. That's how my hair, it's really nice. I haven't experienced any breakage. I haven't experienced any excessive shedding, none of that. My hair has been completely normal. The only thing that I have to say is that I have been noticing split ends, but you know, it's nothing to just cut it off and that's it. You know, with curly hair, you could just do a lopsided cut and nobody will know because your hair is curly. It's just gonna curl back up in any old way, you know? So, So I was really afraid to try color in the beginning when I was thinking about this because I was afraid of my hair being dry and brittle. I've heard so many horror stories about you know, people's hair breaking off. But if you don't want your hair to break off, just take care of it. I mean, it's really simple, you know. It does require a lot of time, I will say that. It's time consuming, but you know, you shower every day. So, you know, when you're in the shower, maybe that third day, you know, just go ahead and do your curly hair routine. But I wish I would have seen somebody do a video on, you know, how to maintain your hair while it has blonde highlights, da da da. But I wouldn't go completely blonde, but the highlights for now, I like it. It's easy to deal with. You know, obviously my hair is dark. I have a chocolate brown base in my hair. So, and I only highlighted the top of my hair and then underneath. All right, y'all, so that was all for my experience for having highlights for 6 months. I told you everything from the products I use to some maintenance ideas and just my overall thoughts and feelings about the highlights. Make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe, or comment down below your favorite products for your LOC method. Also, you can comment down below any video ideas you want to see from me. You can also comment down below your channels and let me know so I can check out your channels. I could have some new people to watch. Alright, so that's it for this video. Thank you for watching and bye-bye.